take your coat?
What are you doing in there?
I was just trying to make your day go a little bit better.
Oh.
Here, come, rest your weary bod. There we go. Here. There we go. Wait. Whoa, no, rest yourself there. It's been a hard day at work, hasn't it, huh?
Well.
There we go. There we go, a little mental massage. There,
Mork.
You cozy?
Well, yeah, I really appreciate what you're doing, but I haven't even been to work yet. I brought it all home with me. See?
Oh, then the Algerian mud rub is out. Mind.
What?
How come you haven't told me what you're doing as a newspaper yet?
Because I'm not supposed to tell anybody. All right. But you got to promise not to tell anybody else.
My lips are stapled.
Okay. See, I'm working at the Boulder Journal for a couple of weeks. They hired me to answer the mail that comes into their Lonely Hearts column.
What's a Lonely Hearts column? Oh, I know. Spare parts for donors.
No. See, Lonely Hearts column, it's for people who write in and ask for personal advice.
Oh, but why would they want to write in to a total stranger?
I guess sometimes it's easier to bare your soul to someone you don't know. To tell you the truth, I'm kind of nervous about this because I've never done anything like this before.
Oh, Mind, you're good at giving advice like that time you told me not to eat soup with the thin end of the spoon.
Yup. Well, my journalism professor recommended me for the job, and nobody is supposed to know I'm doing this. See, the regular Miss Lonely Hearts is in Reno getting his divorce.
The letters in there? Can I read them, please? I mean, I'm a super intelligent alien with highly attuned powers of sensitivity. Please, please give me a chance. Just one chance. Maybe. I can tell you what that one's about already, too.
Okay, how would a highly evolved being answer this one?
All right.
Dear Miss Lonely Hearts, I found a pair of pantyhose in my husband's pocket. Should I be worried?
Don't panic, they may not be his. I'm a whiz. I'm right there. And next.
Listen to this one.
All right.
Dear Miss Lonely Heart, I've only lived in Boulder a few months, but they've been very lonely months. Somehow men just don't notice me.
Poor guy.
I'm not looking for anyone that unusual. Just a nice guy who's sensitive, likes the same things I like, and is genuinely interested in what I have to say. The trouble is, I'm so busy every day going to school and working in a deli. I hardly have the opportunity to meet anyone. Or maybe I just don't know how. Please help me sign J from New York. This letter's from Jeanie.
Oh, she sounds pretty low, Mind.
Oh, she sure does. Boy, I'd sure like to see her meet a guy like the one she described.
Would that make you happy, Mind?
It sure would.
Well, we've got to help her somehow.
First thing I've got to do is figure out how to answer this letter.
Well, what you have to do, basically, is work out how she doesn't know that you and I know that she knows that she doesn't know that we know it.
I wish it were that easy.
Waitress!
Jeanie.
Oh. More coffee? Sorry, you want a new bag?
Just our checks, please.
Yeah, certainly.
Let's go. Here's your money.
Hi.
Hey, Jeanie. Can I see you for a minute? You know, for the last couple of weeks, you've been walking around in a daze.
Remo, I'm a little lonely.
That's it? How can you be lonely? You got me, you got your friends, you got a television in your room.
Yeah, well, it's not that kind of lonely, Remo. I need a guy who thinks I'm special.
No problem. What about Turk down at the gas station? Remember, he whistled at you? He's a great guy. He once bowled 260.
Thanks, Remo. But a woman needs more than that. Look, I'm not looking for Mr. Perfect here. I just want a guy who's sensitive, likes what I like, cares what I have to say. There's nobody like that around.
Hey, you want to know something? I get lonely, too. I mean, Boulder's a long way from New York. We're a couple of fish out of pollution. It's hard to find your way, but you gotta hang in there. And someday you're gonna meet a great guy who appreciates you as much as I do.
I hope you're right.
I know I'm right. You know, I haven't found the right girl for me either. But figure, why not have fun with the wrong ones while I'm waiting? Meanwhile, we have each other. Hey, listen. Why don't you let me close up for you tonight?
No, I'll close up.
Okay. You know, I'll see you later on when I get home from Turks.
Okay.
You sure you don't mind?
No, sure.
You take it easy, huh?
I'm not going anyplace anyway. Boy. I was just in here closing up.
Oh, she's out here knocking. I think I hurt my hands because I guess I'm such a sensitive guy.
You want to come on in?
Oh, thanks. Can I? You know, I'm really fascinated by delicatessens. I bet you are too, huh?
Mork, you okay?
Sure. I guess okay as a sensitive guy can be.
Whoa! You've got a dirty dish collection, too.
Oh, you collect dirty dishes?
Yeah, for about a week, and then Mindy makes me clean it up.
Can I get you something?
Oh, no thanks.
Then why are you here?
Just to keep you company.
Oh.
What'd you say?
Oh.
Fascinating.
Oh, Mork, I don't understand. The deli's closed.
Well, you know, I was just thinking how much we two have in common.
You're kidding. Like what?
Well, for one thing, we both don't eat live game. And we both love to laugh. Isn't that kind of uncanny?
What? You seem sort of different tonight.
I sure do.
Yeah, well, I gotta finish cleaning up.
Then what are you gonna do?
Walk home?
Maybe I could walk along with you, kind of tag along. We can do this and maybe talk. We could be little walkie-talkies.
You know, no one's walked me home in a real long time.
Well, I'm not worried. I think you remember where it is.
Ooh, look, I made the newspaper. Oh, they printed my first replies in the Lonely Hearts column.
Oh, congrats, kudos, and plaudits.
Thanks.
Well, what'd you tell her?
I shall read it to you.
Well, I should be attentive.
Dear Jay from New York, it's not easy leaving all your friends and moving far away from home. You feel like an island in the midst of a sea of strangers. Took me half an hour to come up with that one.
That's a catchy phrase, Min. Tennessee Williams, move over. Here comes Colorado McConnell.
It's possible that the person you're looking for is somebody you see every day, but are just too busy to notice. Look around you. If he's there, try not to be shy. Reach out and show him how you feel. He might become interested in you if he sees you're interested in him.
Oh, that's wonderful, Min. You're gonna make Abby crabby.
You think? I just hope it helps Jeanie.
I was hoping it yesterday.
You were?
Yeah, I went over to the deli last night and cheered her up.
You didn't tell her about the letters, did you?
No, I just walked her home and gave her a few laughs, that's all.
Oh, that's nice. The worst thing we could do is embarrass her.
I know.
Why are you building a tower of Cheerios?
Because it's hard to stack oatmeal.
Why do I ask? I have to get to class, so I'll see you a little later. Oh, if you get hungry, your peanut butter pagoda's in the refrigerator.
I'll never remember what order they were in.
Row four.
I feel like I'm living on a fault line.
Hi, Mork. Can I come in?
I know you can do it. Just put one foot forward.
I can't came by because I wanted to thank you again for walking me home last night. I really did enjoy it.
I had fun, too, especially leapfrogging over those fire hydrants. Too bad about that dog, huh?
You know, Mork, ever since I moved here, I've sort of felt like an island in a sea of strangers.
That's a catchy phrase. I mean, I know what it's like to be a stranger in a strange land.
Does Mindy know that you walked me home last night?
Oh, yeah. I told her all about it.
How does she feel about that?
Oh, she says if you're happy, she's happy.
Yeah. Mindy once told me that you and she were just good friends. Is that still the way it is?
Oh, yeah. We're buddies.
And that's all?
Well, that's enough. Oh.
Well, there's something that I forgot to give you last night.
Why did you do that?
Well, because I really hope that maybe we can keep seeing each other like we did last night.
Maybe we could do something very special, like ringing doorbells and hide.
Dear Miss Lonely Hearts, your answer to my letter helped me a lot. When I took the time to look around me, I found someone who was there all along, but I never realized how wonderful he is. He came to my house the other night for dinner, and we had a terrific time. He's so thoughtful. He brought me this little gift, which will always remind me of him. Before dinner, we sat together for a while and talked. The night had just begun, and already we were closer. Before we knew it, we found ourselves holding hands. Pretty soon, one thing led to another. When it came time for dinner, I realized he's one of the few guys I've met who tries to be a gentleman. And in addition to all his other good qualities, he really knows how to make me laugh. He has everything I've ever wanted in a guy. He's so sensitive, gentle. He wouldn't hurt a fly. Good listener. He really cares about whatever I have to say. And you know, he likes the same things that I like. It's almost like a dream come true. I just hope it won't be long before he starts getting serious. Thanks again for your kind help. Gratefully, Jay from New York.
She must have found somebody great.
Hope it won't be too long before he starts getting serious. Serious. If she wants serious, I'll give her serious.
Hi, Mork.
Hello, Jean, and I really need that.
Are you glad to see me?
Indeed I am, Jean. Make no mistake about that.
Is everything all right? You seem sort of strange.
I'm merely one of my serious moods, Jeanie. See?
Is Mindy home?
No, she's not here right now. But you can ask anyone, Mr. Bickley, Exidor, they know her. They'll vouch for me. I am not a liar.
Oh, it was such a hectic day. I thought it would be fun just to come over and we could sit and talk for a while.
Well, perhaps I could tell you one of my favorite jokes, Jeanie. What's black and white and red all over? I know you're thinking a penguin with a heat rash. No, no, it's not that. And it's not a nun with a sunburn either. Now, come here. I'll tell you the secret. Did you hear a hum? We'll have to discuss this at another time.
You are too much, Mork.
I'm home.
She's home.
Oh. Hi,
Mindy.
Hi. I've been wanting to tell you how much fun I've been having with Mork.
Fun with Mork?
Well, I've been showing a good time for the past 2 days. Wink, wink.
And I hope it'll be for a lot more days to come. Oh, Mind, I'm so glad it's okay with you.
Me too.
Oh. Do you remember that blue gloss I borrowed from you last week?
Yeah.
Well, it's in the bedroom right now. Could you get it for me, please?
Yeah, sure.
Thanks. Don't tell me you're the terrific guy she's been writing me about.
Yep, it's me.
Don't you realize what you've done?
But you said it was nice if I made her happy. Then when she wanted to see me again, I thought that was even nicer.
Oh, Mark. Jeanie wants more than just a friend. She wants somebody she can spend her life with.
Oh, you mean like you and I share our lives?
And then some.
Jeez, I forgot all about this blouse. Mork, if you like it, I could wear it tonight.
Would you like to sit down? Jeanie, I think we have a problem here. A big one. I don't know how to tell you this, but I think I have to before it goes too far. If it hasn't already. See, I'm Miss Lonely Hearts.
What?
I've been reading your letters, and I guess so has Mork. And see, I was only trying to help. I got this job at Jeanie. Wait, Jeanie.
I gotta go back.
Well, you told me you wanted me to make her happy.
Yeah, but the trouble is you made her ecstatic.
Oh, what a tangled web I weave.
Understand. Why'd you have to write those letters? Why couldn't you come talk to me? I'm your brother.
I didn't want to dump my problems on you, Remo. I'm gonna drown my sorrows in Rocky Road.
What good are these shoulders of steel if my little sister can't lean on them once in a while?
I made a fool of myself, didn't I, Remo?
It's not your fault. How are you supposed to know Mork was such a heartbreaker? I'd have never guessed it.
I'm just so confused.
I don't blame you. Mork should have known better. But whatever happened, I just can't believe that Mork or Mindy would do anything to hurt you. You know, if it had happened to me, I think I'd look at it in this way. Hey, at least I had a little fun. I didn't sit at home with a long face. I came out of my shell, and I'm not pregnant.
Can we talk to Jeanie?
Hey, guys, you know, I don't think this is a real good time.
Please, it's important.
Well, okay, but try and make her feel better, would you?
Hi.
I'll be in my room. And don't worry about the ironing. I'll take care of it.
Jeanie, I just want to say I'm really sorry. And it was really dumb of me to think I could just step into a job and then become Miss Know-It-All. I mean, who am I to go around telling people what to do with their lives?
I was just trying to be a friend. I didn't know you wanted and then some. I'm sorry, Jean.
Wait, guys. You see, ever since I moved here to Boulder, I sort of had a hard time fitting in. I never told anybody. And then finally I wrote Miss Lonely Hearts. And she told me that this wonderful guy might be right in front of me. But he was. And that all I had to do was to reach out to him, which I did. And guys, I had so much fun. But do you know why? Because you both helped bring out qualities in me that I forgot I had.
You did?
Terrific qualities. And you made me realize why I haven't met that right guy. I haven't been the right girl.
Oh, you always have been to us.
I love you, Mork. I love you, Mindy. Thanks to you guys, I'm starting to love myself again.
Oh, I'm glad.
Me too.
Me too.
Well, how's it look?
Remo, did you ever write a letter to Miss Lonely Hearts signed Confused?
Mork calling Orson. Come in, Orson. Mork calling Orson. Come in, Orson.
Mork calling Orson. Come in, Orson. Hey, move it, will you? Come on.
What did you learn about this week, Mork?
Oh, about shyness, Your Highness.
Why do you toy with me so?
Well, because you're there, sir. You see, sir, shyness is a major problem here on Earth. It keeps people apart when they want to be together. They see someone they want to know, but they're afraid to approach them.
What causes this shyness?
Well, sir, I have a friend who became shy when she moved away from home to a place where she didn't know anybody.
You did that too, Mork.
I know, sir. At first, it was very hard to feel at home here. I mean, people were so strange. They talk in heavy accents. They drink with their mouths. They sit on what we play checkers with. I finally overcame it because I was willing to reach out.
What about your friend?
Well, she spent a lot of time feeling lonely. But then she realized her best chance of going out was to be more outgoing.
That reminds me of an old Orkin saying.
Me too, sir. If one stays too long in his shell, he'll wind up nuts. On that same note, sir. Nanu.